Students of class 9, you had already learnt digestive system first unit, in which you have learnt thoroughly about the structure of teeth, structure of premolar and the buccal cavity, dentition, etc. Now in the same unit, digestive system part 1 you are going to learn, that is about digestive system, what are the organs of digestive system. All that you are going to learn. Got it? In a human digestive system. Human digestive system, digestion of food, absorption of digested food, that you are going to learn in this lesson. Now, digestive system and digestion. Digestion actually takes place in four stages. Ingestion, food enters digestive system in a location called mouth, through mouth. In digestion, there are two steps, mechanical digestion and chemical digestion. The previous unit, the mouth and teeth, you have learnt about mechanical digestion. Food is physically broken down into small pieces. It's done in two places, mouth and stomach. In chemical digestion, digestive enzymes break down food pieces into smaller microscopic molecules. It takes place in mouth, stomach and small intestine. The digestion begins in the mouth, ends in the small intestine. And at the third stage of nutrition or digestion is absorption. Third stage of nutrition, absorption, where water and digested food enter the bloodstream from digestive system. Small intestine and large intestine, it takes place. There are specified organs for that. Villi, etc. In the last stage of nutrition, that is fourth stage of nutrition, is expelling out the waste material, that is called excretion. Undigested food leaves the system, got it, and goes out. It takes place in large intestine and thrown out by a pore or opening called anus. The human digestive system consists of alimentary canal and digestive glands. The alimentary canal is a long coiled tube at about 9 meters long, and it starts with mouth and ends with the anus. An anterior opening, the mouth, and the posterior opening called anus. The mouth leads into buccal cavity or oral cavity. The oral cavity has number of teeth and muscular tongue, and about lips and the functions of mouth, lips, tongue, all that you have already learned. Oral cavity leads into a short pharynx, which serves as a common passage for food and air. Got it, children? In this regard, in the pharynx, what actually happens? How the food is entering into the esophagus, that is called swallowing. Got it? That process of swallowing you are going to learn. Here you have another organ called the larynx. The larynx is located at the entrance of the windpipe, is pulled upward to bring it close to the back of the tongue with a flap called epiglottis. That closes its opening. Thus, the only passage available to be swallowed food is that of gullet or esophagus. The other name of esophagus is gullet. Got it? A cartilaginous flap called epiglottis prevents the entry of food into glottis. Opening of the wide windpipe is closed during swallowing. Got it? And how swallowing takes place, you are going to learn. Here you are learning two things. If the food is going in the wrong way, by any chance, the food we swallow gets into windpipe, the immediate coughing to forcibly throw out the wrongly entered substance is, got it, immediate coughing. Got it? That is the reflex shown by pharynx, the coughing. What it? Esophagus is a thin long tube which extends posteriorly, passing through the neck. Thorax, got it, and diaphragm, and leads to a J-shaped bag-like structure called stomach. What will happen here in the esophagus? Once the food reaches the esophagus, it is conducted behind a special movement called peristalsis. You can see the salivary glands, mouth, esophagus, and other organs of the digestive system here. Got it? Before going for the stomach, we are going to learn now about swallowing and a process called peristalsis. Once the food reaches the esophagus, it is conducted behind by a special movement called peristalsis. Peristalsis is the wave of constrictions caused by circular muscles of the gut pushing the food along. As the wave passes, the circular muscles relax. Peristalsis occurs through all regions of the gut. Mucus secreted by all regions of the gut is a slimy fluid which lubricates the food. Is it clear, children? So how swallowing takes place? Swallowing takes place by tongue presses upward and backward against the roof of the mouth and forces the bolus. Here the food is called bolus. Food, the ball of chewed food, into the throat or the pharynx. From there, then you have learnt about larynx, then into the esophagus. Got it? So the two processes here we have learnt are swallowing and peristalsis. Now we are entering into the next part called stomach. A muscular sphincter called gastroesophageal sphincter. It is also called pylorus sphincter. Regulates the opening of esophagus into stomach. Stomach has three major parts. Cardiac portion into which the esophagus opens. That is called cardiac sphincter. Got it? And fundic region where the food is stored. And pyloric portion which opens into the first part of small intestine. Got it? And the opening of the stomach into duodenum is guarded by the pyloric sphincter. Got it? So, about stomach. Stomach is an elastic bag located below the diaphragm. In an average adult, it can hold 2 to 3 liters of food. Its walls are highly muscular and churn the food thoroughly to make the gastric juice secreted by the inner lining. The opening of the stomach into the intestine is called pylorus or pyloric sphincter. It has a ring of muscles called sphincter to keep the opening closed like a valve to prevent food passing from the stomach until it is thoroughly churned up. It also prevents process called regurgitation. Okay, regurgitation from the duodenum. A similar sphincter termed as cardiac sphincter is present at the end of the stomach to prevent backflow of food into esophagus. Got it? Here you will be learning another thing called vomiting. Sometimes when the stomach is overloaded or disturbed, vomiting occurs in which cardiac sphincter opens and reverse wave muscular contractions called antiperistalsis is caused, throwing the contents out through the mouth. You already learned what is meant by peristalsis. Wave-like constrictions caused by the circular muscles of the gut pushing the food along. Isn't it? The same thing happens reverse antiperistalsis. Sometimes too spicy foods, some poisonous foods, which stomach will not accept, it will start coming out. That process is called regurgitation or vomiting. Now, small intestine has three important parts, namely duodenum, jejunum, ileum. Duodenum is a short upper part next to stomach. It is about 12 inches finger length. Duo means 2 and deni means 10. What it dvajasa, even in Sanskrit, duodenum is a word derived from Sanskrit, dvadasha, 12 inches. The common bile duct opens into this part. Jejunum, next short region of about 2 meters. Got it? It is jejunum, and which means empty, because it's nearly almost empty. It is called jejunum. Even this is derived from Sanskrit. Jathara, jejunum and all. Got it? So, jejunum, if it is after dissection in postmortem children, it should be always empty. If there is any substance like poison or anything, by looking at that substance, they will say by what means death happened. Okay, it's one of the evidence for the postmortem. Now, ileum, about 4 meters. Ileum means twist or roll, referring to the twisting movements of this part. Ileum got its name. The inner lining of the ileum is made into greater number of tiny finger-like projections called villi. These villi enormously increase the inner surface of the outer body surface, which facilitates the absorption of digested food. Between the villi are very small holes through which the intestinal juice secreted by its glandular cells poured into lumen of intestine. Each villus is covered by a single cell thick epithelium. Inside the villi are contained an artery, vein, interconnecting blood capillaries and a lymph vessel called lacteal. See the picture of digestive system. Got it? Each mucosa layer has got irregular folds. These foldings are called villi. Got it? They increase surface area enormously. Villi are supplied with a network of capillaries and large lymph vessels called lacteals. Is that clear? The small intestine serves both for digestion and absorption. It receives two digestive juices, the bile and the pancreatic juice in the duodenum. And its own walls secrete the intestinal juice in the ileum. Got it? So what are the advantages as a will adaptations and advantages of having villi in the small intestine? Adaptations of the ileum for absorption of digested food. So intestines also act as a, you already learned, they also act as a absorption organ as well as digestive organ. It is very long, more surface area is provided. The large number of villi further increase the surface area for absorption. Single celled epithelium, it is narrow, which slows down the movement of food, thereby allowing absorption. Is it clear? So villi are very important organs in the case of absorption. Got it? Now we are moving to a few digestive glands associated with the alimentary canal. They are salivary glands, liver and pancreas. Saliva is mainly produced by three main glands. Got it? The three pairs of salivary glands. They are parotid glands near the cheek, located just in front and beneath the ear, each ear. Submandibular glands lying close to the inner side of the lower jaw on each side. And sublingual glands below the tongue. Ducts from each gland transport the secreted saliva into the mouth. Small quantities of saliva keep secreting at all times. While eating the salivary flow, it considerably increases. Sometimes even the slight smell or just a thought of tasty food can cause increased flow of saliva, resulting in watering of the mouth. Got it? About 1000 to 1500, got it, enough to fill 5 to 7 empty bottles of saliva, soft drink bottles, can be produced, children. Can you guess? So much. Saliva is very slightly acidic, fluid containing water about 99%. 99% is water and 6.8 is pH value. Salts, mucus and an enzyme called salivary amylase, and it's also called as styline. Earlier they used to call it as styline. Got it? Functions of saliva. Saliva moistens and lubricates the inner lining of the oral cavity and surface of the tongue to facilitate speaking and swallowing. Imagine if it's not wet, each time when you make sound, open and close your mouth, there'll lot of sound, children, like how our plastic and steel boxes will give, like that. Got it? Moistens and lubricates food, which again help in swallowing. Acts as a solvent, dissolving some food particles to stimulate taste buds of the tongue. Helps food particles to stick together to form bolus so that they can be swallowed in mass. Digests starch, its enzyme by name ptyalin or salivary amylase, converts starch into maltose. This explains why if boiled rice is chewed very well, it begins to taste sweet. Got it? Whenever you take rice or any of the grains, my children, chew, at the end you will get sweetness. That is, the maltose is released by the action of maltose. Starch, ptyalin or salivary amylase present in saliva gives maltose a disaccharide, cleans the mouth and tends to destroy germs to prevent tooth decay. Whenever your mouth dries, you feel that mouth is stinking, isn't it? So it is the one, salivary juice or saliva is the one which cleans the mouth. Dryness in the mouth due to less water in saliva gives feeling of thirst to replenish body water, thus saliva aids in water balance in the body. The water balance in the body is maintained by saliva. Got it? And finally, the back part of the root, no, children? It is palate. Got it? That I've forgotten about it. The tongue touches the palate. Got it? Now we are going for the another organ called liver. Got it? That's another structure. Liver is a yellowish, purple color, big organ. Got it? When you talk about glands, this is the biggest gland in our body. The liver is. It is trilobed structure. Liver is a trilobed structure. And it produces a juice called bile juice. It weighs about 1.5 kg on average. And its color is purple, that is reddish brown organ. And it is located upper right side of the abdomen, just below the diaphragm. You can see that in picture. Got it? Liver has many functions. It controls blood sugar level. Got it? It regulates blood sugar. It also controls amino acids level. Helps in deamination. It helps in synthesis of fetal red blood cells. It produces red blood cells in the embryo. It helps in storage of iron, copper, vitamins, etc. It helps in detoxification. It helps in production of fibrinogen and prothrombin, which help in blood clotting enzymes, and production of heat by cellular metabolism, a regulation of blood volume by acting as a temporary store of excess of water, and helps in excretion of toxic and metallic poisons, destruction of red blood cells. Dead and red blood cells are destroyed by the liver. Got it? So many functions other than digestion, liver does. Got it, children? It's the largest gland. Got it? And the hepatic lobules are the structural and functional units of a liver containing hepatic cells. Got it? Each lobule is covered by a thin connective tissue sheath called Glisson's capsule. Got it? Now we are going for the bile juice. Bile is yellow, green and watery fluid produced in the liver, which is transported through hepatic duct. The hepatic duct is joined by the cystic duct to form the common bile duct. The bile may flow directly into duodenum or, as it is generally happens, gets temporarily stored in gallbladder. You can see the green color gallbladder in the diagram. The color of the bile is due to certain pigments, namely biliverdin and bilirubin, produced by the breakdown of the dead or worn out red blood cells. Now I told you blood, one of the liver function. Bile contains lot of sodium bicarbonate, which neutralizes the acid content of the food received from the stomach and makes it alkaline. Till now the food is acidic because gastric juice contains an acid called hydrochloric acid. Got it? In the next unit you will be learning how food changes from acidic to alkaline. Got it? Received from the stomach and makes alkaline to enable the pancreatic and intestinal enzymes to act upon. Bile salts reduce the surface tension of the fats and break them into tiny droplets, and they are called, that process is called emulsification. Emulsification is for providing greater surface area for the action of enzyme. Is it clear? The bile secreted by the liver, and its actions you have learned. Now the third organ is called pancreas. Pancreas is both exocrine and endocrine organ, situated between the limbs of U-shaped duodenum, in between stomach, and it comes like that. It's a leaf-like structure. Got it? The exocrine portion secretes alkaline pancreatic juice containing enzyme. The endocrine portion secretes hormones, namely insulin and glucagon. Got it? And it has, pancreatic duct has an aperture. Got it? Which opens commonly into the bile duct. Got it? The pancreatic juice contains three enzymes, namely amylopsin, trypsin and stepsin. Got it, children? Thank you.